Hi guys, this is Purti from Leverage Edu, and in this video today I'll talk about the IELTS speaking exam and I'll tell you top 5 mistakes that you might be making which is stopping you from getting a good band score. Now I take classes at the Leverage Life platform which you can know about by visiting this website or calling us at the number. So while taking the classes, I take modules for speaking test and I practice with my students part 1, 2 and 3 and the full test. And I see that they make mistakes continuously. Now even though I give them feedback on the kind of answers that they provide me and it is very individual and personalized, but still I see that there are some common or recurring mistakes. So I thought I'll make a video on the mistakes that they are making, which you also might be making, and you should know about this probably if you're not making all, maybe some. So get to know about this so that you don't make it and you can get a good score in the exam. So let's start. So the first mistake that you might be making for your speaking exam is being too nervous. Now trust me, I understand it is an exam, a life-changing one that is. So it is bound that one is going to be nervous, but if you get nervous, you'll stress out, you'll hesitate, fumble during the exam, or the worst of all, you'll get confused and not say anything at all. So relax, don't be too stressed about it. Remember that it's just an informal conversation with the examiner. Just think of it like speaking to a friend or a colleague of yours. Think of it as a casual conversation rather than as an exam. Of course, you have to talk informally. Don't be very, very informal, but don't be formal either. Don't try and use big academic words for the exam. Your style of speaking should be like you're talking to somebody that you know. So, you know, you're more chilled out, you're relaxed, and you're able to process things better. So when you're relaxed and you're not nervous, it shows in your body language and your brain is also able to process things easily. So just chill, relax and don't take a lot of stress and take this exam as a casual conversation rather than an exam. Train your mind into thinking that you're just having a chat with somebody, no big deal. Now let's move on to the next mistake that you might be making, which is hampering your speaking skills. So the next mistake is not communicating at all. The number one thing that IELTS is checking is, can you communicate? So there are two things that will come up here. One is, do not remain silent. No matter what the question is, don't go blank, do not freeze. It's a big no-no. Always try and come up with an answer with some fact or an example, your personal story or somebody else's story to provide as an answer. So for example, the examiner asks you a question and you don't know much about it. That's absolutely fine. You don't have to provide a lot of points to the examiner. You can only say one point that you know and you know, tell that to the examiner that this is the only thing that you know. So for instance, the examiner asks you the question. You can just say, well, I don't really know much about it. The only thing I know is this. Or you can say, well, I don't have really an idea about this question, but I just know one thing, which is this. That thing could be anything that you might have read about in the newspaper or in an article, watched something about it in the TV or overheard your neighbors talking about it. You just have to come up with an answer, try and bring in any detail that you can and don't go blank. Now the second thing that is you need to be careful of here is they don't want you to demonstrate that you can use big or impressive words. Now I know vocabulary accounts for 25% of your total speaking score, but there are some students who just enter the examination room with the intention of trying and impressing the examiner with the words. But be careful that you have to use them within the context and correctly, right? If you just use words or if you stop in between to think about, oh, what was that word I read about this topic, or I should probably use better synonym for this. If you do all this thinking, that you're going to miss out the answer. Okay, so remember, yes, you have to use a good range of vocabulary, but you have to use it within the context and with relevance. Plus, you have to use it naturally. So the more natural, effortless you are, the better it is. The next mistake you might be making is having no clarity. Now, clarity comes under pronunciation, and pronunciation accounts for 25% of your marks.
So, can the examiner understand what you're saying is the big issue. It does not mean whether you have a British accent or an American accent. Remember, accent does not matter here. What matters is whatever you say has to be understandable to the examiner. Sometimes you will also notice that there are certain influences of the mother tongue or the state or country that you live in over the words that you pronounce. So make sure that while you are practicing, you listen and identify these words and pronounce them correctly. You can also take help from us and get immediate feedback on your speaking in the live classes. Refer to the website or the number for more details. And you can also watch the detailed video on pronunciation here.
Now the next mistake is a huge one, and that is not developing your answers enough. Now remember that IELTS is checking your ability to use the language and how well you do it. So if you don't say enough, then how will the examiner check you? There are many students who just give one word or one line answers. For example, there's a very common question, do you work or study? And if you just give the answer, I work or I study or even I'm a student, then that is not enough. Absolutely not. So always develop your answers, always enhance your answers and give extended answers.
You need to show to the examiner that you can use a range of vocabulary, a range of sentence structures. You can communicate, you can have a conversation and use the language flexibly. So do not give one-line answers. There are various ways of extending your answers. You can give details, you can give reasons for it, give examples, talk about your personal experience, give personal stories, talk about things that you might have heard or read about that topic, talk about the past, contrast it with the future, things that used to happen in the past, what it is going to be in the future. So these are various ways in which you can extend your answers. So do it.
And the last one is overthinking. Now I'm sure almost every student does this, and I always tell the same thing, don't overthink. So instead of giving an answer or talking naturally, you're going in your mind like about grammar, pronunciation, ideas, all of those things, and this hampers your fluency. So instead of talking naturally, you're thinking, should I use that word or what grammar structure should I use? Am I giving enough answers? What is the examiner thinking about what I'm saying? Is my pronunciation correct? So all of these, you're just overthinking about it. So just focus on communicating naturally and you should be fine. So guys, these were the top 5 mistakes that you might be making and which is hampering your score. Tell me in the comments below any of these mistakes that you are making. I'm sure you're not going to do it now. So that is it for today. I'll see you next time with my next video. Make sure that you like it and share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel in order to view more videos.